Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about three different principles of redux, which we have already talked about. Here we will talk those three different principles in terms of code. Okay. So three different principles. One was redux maintains a single state object. This is the first single source of truth, you can say. Redux, I mean this store inside a redux is a single source of truth, or you can say redux maintains a single source of truth as a plain JavaScript object. So why we are calling it like this? Because in redux, if I talk about the object, this can be your plain JavaScript object. It can have a profile information, okay, your account information. Whatever passwords, whatever we can think of, all the information it will maintain. And this can be your client side state object. Okay. So this plain, this JavaScript object is nothing but a single source of truth, and your store will manage this. Store will have it. Okay. And all your client, like if you are using React with Redux, then this for React, this store or this JSON object is a single source of truth, because from this only you will get the profile information, account information, the application settings and all. Okay, so this is a single source of truth and store will manage it. Okay, this information can be managed or can be coming from multiple reducers. Okay, there may be a profile reducer, account reducers, settings reducers. Store will combine all these reducers together and it will create this single JSON object. So we are calling that as a single source of truth. Okay, this is the first principle. Second principle is the state is read only. Why we are calling a redux state as read only? Because in the redux we have this state object, and this state object cannot be updated or cannot be written. We always need to return a new state by not modifying the existing state. You just create a deep copy of it, update an attribute and return the new state. Currently there is an array, you just run a move map onto it, filter onto it, return the new array, or use a spread operator and return a new array. Okay, so these are state are read only. Okay, third thing is update in the state. Update in state is made by pure functions, right? Pure functions, these are called as reducers. Okay, and this is nothing but your state object. Now if we combine all these three things together, right? Update in the state made by the pure functions when action triggers, right? Now coming to our architecture, what do we have is, we have action. Action will come, this is our reducer. Reducer will update the data, and this is our store. Consider that in store, we have, now this is our store. Okay, this is our store. Now, whenever action will come, so a simple action can be simple as, okay, I have a type. Type is, you can say, update profile. Okay, and there may be some data coming with it. Okay, this is your action. Action will have a type and data. Okay, and I will have a third thing is a reducer. Reducer will be nothing but a simple function like const reducer equal to some function, and in this function you have a current state object and action name, and here you will have, okay, simple, currently I'm considering that I'm getting only single action. So what I will do is const object, I can either create a deep copy of it or whatever you want. Okay, I need to just return the new state object without modifying the current state. So here I will do is I will just create a deep copy of it. Okay, I have a profile, so I created a new object by saying by just getting a deep copy of this profile using state.profile. I got the current copy. Now I will actually update whatever I wanted to update in this object.profile equal to action.payload, and I will return object. In that case, what I did is I just created a copy of my current object. I created a new object from the current state. I modified its one property, right? And I'm returning it. I'm not modifying directly the state. Okay. So this is how my reducers will work. Okay. This is my function. This is my reducer. Reducers are nothing but a pure functions. Pure functions are those functions wherever if you keep passing the same inputs, the output will always remain same, like function AB, right? So here comes const add, right? Here you are passing A comma B. Whatever you are returning, whatever you are passing as A and B, if you keep passing the same argument, you will always return same value. Pure functions are nothing but doing asynchronous execution, not dealing with any network call, file read, or any kind of asynchronous operations, right? Those are pure functions. So reducers are nothing but a pure functions based on the actions which are coming. So here we will be checking something like action.type if you have multiple actions coming, like update profile. If this is update profile, then do this. Otherwise, if we are not getting anything, returns current state, right? This is how the reducers will work. Reducers are the pure functions. Actions are nothing but this JSON object which will have a type and some data. These can be synchronous actions, asynchronous actions, and a store is nothing but the combination of all these reducers. So in the application, you can have a profile reducers, account reducers. Consider that my initial state. So this is actually your initial state. So what I can say is my state is initialized with initial state, and my initial state is nothing but here I do have profile only. Similarly, we can have other reducers which are managing the account reducers, settings reducers and all. Okay, so you can have multiple reducers in your whole application. So what we need to do is if this state is managing profile, another is managing settings, another is managing account, we have to combine all these reducers together and we have to create a one single state object for the store. So store is nothing but, now if we come into the final definition of each and every component, actions are nothing but this JSON object which will have a type and payload, or this is optional property. Payload is optional property, but type it will always have, like type is add, decrease, update, delete, whatever the action you are sending. Okay, this is your action. Reducers are nothing but a pure JavaScript functions which takes current state actions and will return you the new state. Okay, you can say this is a state function, right? What it does is it is taking the current state and action and returning the new state. Similarly, we have a store. Store is nothing but a combination of all reducers combined. So they are creating a single state object because it is combining all the reducers, profile reducers, setting reducer, account reducers, and creating a single state tree object. This is what your whole application will manage as a client-side state, single state tree object. Okay, now any of your component will come. If they want profile, they will get it. If they want, because this is a store object, single source of truth for your whole client application. This is the client side state. They can get account, they can get settings, they can get profile. Okay, and based on the particular action, we will be updating profile, account, settings. Okay, so these are actually three principles of Redux in broader way. Okay, this is all about theoretical. Now we will go ahead and we will understand Redux first in terms of code.